أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين أما بعد Brothers and sisters In the last session I discussed with you Al-Qasam The element of Al-Qasam and Jawab Al-Qasam, and we read in detail the various aspects of Jawab Al-Qasam and the instrument of emphasis in each case. Now, I propose to explain to you in this session another important element, grammatical element, which is closely related to Al-Qasam. This is called Ijtima'u Al-Qasami Wa-Shart. It's written there, Ijtima'u Al-Qasami Wa-Shart, Wa-Sharti. That is, combining the Qasam with the Shart. This is very frequent in the Quranic Arabic. I'll explain to you now. You know shart. In arad, in aradta, an tadrusa, اللغة العربية إن أردت أن تدرس اللغة العربية فإني مستعد إن أردت أن تدرس اللغة العربية فإني مستعد. What does it mean? I'm ready. If you want to learn Arabic language, if you want to study Arabic language, I am ready. So you have this sentence made up of shart and jawab al-shart. إن أردت أن تدرس اللغة العربية that is shart. فإني مستعد that is جواب الشرط. جواب الشرط. Now we want to introduce al-qasam here. Introduce the qasam here. That is, supposing we say, Wallahi in Aratta. Wallahi in Aratta. So it will be a combination of Qasam and Ashar. Now we usually do not say Wallahi. There is a letter, a lam, which denotes the Qasam. This letter is lam. We write like this: la in, la in. Hamza has become is written here on the ya because in the middle, la in. This lam is called al lam. الموطئة للقسم. You can say موطئة أو الموطئة. وطئة وطئة يطأوا. What type of verb is this? مثال واوي وطئ يطأوا. فعل يفعل. سمع يسمع group. وطئ يطأوا. يطأوا ياط ألف همزة is on over the ألف. يطأوا. وطئ يطأ means to trample under the foot. وطئ to trample under the foot. وطئ وطأ فعل وطأ is for مبالغة to trample continuously. So Tawti'a has come to mean an introduction. Tawti'atun. Masdar watta'a yuwatti'u tawti'atun. Like hanna'a yuhanni'u tahni'atun. Rabba yurabbi tarbiyatun. If the lam of the verb is hamza or ya, the masdar is on the measure of taf'ila. Taf'ilatun. Hanna'a yuhanni'u tahni'atun. رَبَّا يُرَبِّي تَرْبِيَةٌ. So, وَطَّأَ, that means walking on a ground so that you make it walkable. What I mean? Passable. So, that is تَوْطِئَ. مُوَطَّأَ, اسم المفعول مُوَطَّأٌ. مُوَطَّأٌ. موطئٌ. If you know, if you have heard it, the collection of hadith which Imam Malik prepared is called al-muwatta'u. 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 Which means, in a sense, a beaten track. By constantly walking on it, it has become a road on which you can easily walk. So muwatta, that means he has made it easy for people to understand, collected them together in a manner which is easy to have access to. Now here, allamul muwatti'ah or allamul muwatti'ah to lil qasam, the lam which paves the way for the qasam. It is not qasam itself, but it is an indication of the qasam. It's a little lamb which paves the way for the qasam. So wherever you find la'in, it's very frequent in the Quran. If you find la'in, so please be sure that lam, this lam is lam al-muttal al-qasam. There is a qasam there. As if you say, Wallahi, and then you start the shart and jawab al-shart. Okay. But there is a very important thing to remember here, that when the qasam is introduced to a shart sentence, what happens? Please remember. Please note here. Where is the jawab here? This jawab. This should confirm to the qasam, not to the shart. It should confirm to the qasam, not to the shart. So here, for example, we have فَإِنِّي مُسْتَعِدٌ. Supposing you say, Wallahi, how do you say, جواب الشرط, Wallahi, No, only here. We want to make this جواب القصب. Wallahi inni musta'iddun. Fa will go. Fa is here because it is jawab shart. But you say, I want to say by Allah I'm ready, I will say Wallahi inni musta'iddun. Or better we say Wallahi inni la musta'iddun with inna and lam. So what happens here? If you introduce the lam here, please note, if you introduce the lam here, you have to remove the fa from here. You follow me? So we say, لَإِنْ أَرَدْتَ أَنْ تَدْرُسَ اللُّغَةَ الْعَرَبِيَّةَ إِنِّي مُسْتَعِدٌ. The fa will go. Please understand this. Ordinary people who have a little knowledge of Arabic, if they find this, they will immediately take their pen and put a fa there. It has happened to me. Some people taking the pen and putting the fa. So لَإِنْ أَرَدْتَ أَنْ تَدْرُسَ اللُّغَةَ الْعَرَبِيَّةَ إِنِّي مُسْتَعِدٌ. Fa will go because now it has become from جواب الشرط, it has now become جواب القسم. Why جواب القسم? Because we have reduced the قسم to this sentence. And where is the قسم? It is the lam. The lam indicates, it's not the قسم itself, but it is an indication of the قسم. اللام الموطئة للقسم أو اللام الموطئة للقسم. Another sentence, إن سافرت. سافرت معك. If you travel, I'll travel with you. إن سافرت. This is ماضي, but because it is short, the meaning is مستقبل, future. إن سافرت. If you travel, it's not ماضي anymore. If you say سافرت سافرت without إن, then it is past tense ماضي. But if you say إن, إن سافرت, it is future. إن سافرت, if you travel, سافرت معك. Now, let us introduce لام. لا إن سافرت. How do you say in future, Wallahi, I will travel by Allah. Wallahi, Wallahi, لأسافرن، والله لأسافرن، لا أسافرن معك. So we say لئن سافرت لأسافرن معك. The خبر has now, the جواب has now changed. It has, it was جواب الشرط, now it has become جواب القسم. لئن سافرت, if you say إن سافرت without لام, إن سافرت سافرت معك. But if you say لئن سافرت لأسافرن معك. The جواب here confirms to the قسم and not to the شرط. Now inshallah we read these ayat, which are examples of the combination of qasam and ashart. And you will understand more when we read these examples, inshallah. Now the first is jumla ismiya musbata. Jumla ismiya musbata. If you remember, if it is jawab ashart, جملة اسمية مثبتة, it must take fa. This is a question, the first sentence. إني إن لا إن أردت أن تدرس اللغة العربية إني مستعدون. Should we say إني لا مستعدون, as I told you before? You can, the جواب القسم, if it is جملة اسمية, it takes إن and لام or both. One of them or both. You can say, either you say, إن أردت أن تدرس اللغة العربية لأنا مستعد. لأنا مستعد. Only لام. لأنا مستعد. Or you say, إني مستعد. Or better than that, إني لا مستعد. إن plus لام, which is more emphatic than only one of them. So جملة اسمية مثبتة, if it is جواب الشرط, it must take فا, as we have seen here. فأنا إن أردت أن تدرس اللغة العربية فأنا مستعد. فأنا أو فإني مستعد. You can say إني, that's not necessary. You can say فأنا مستعد. But if you add لام, introduce قسم, then you say لئن أردت أن تدرس اللغة العربية إني لمستعد, or إني مستعد, or the third option is لأنا مستعد. لأنا, can we join لام and إنا together? لام and إنا, you can't join. Either you say لا لأنا مستعد, or you say إني مستعد, or إنا introduced with the, attached to the ism, and لام attached to the خبر. Now we'll take the first example. لَئِنِ اتَّبَعْتُمْ شُعَيْبًا إِنَّكُمْ إِذًا لَخَاسِرُونَ. لَئِنِ اتَّبَعْتُمْ شُعَيْبًا, شُعَيْب, you know the prophet شُعَيْب was in Madian. لَئِنِ اتَّبَعْتُمْ, اتَّبَعَ, which bab is this? Eighth. تَبِعَ to follow, تَبِعَ to follow. تَبِعَ يَتْبَعُ, تَبِعَ يَتْبَعُ. تَبِعَ is literal following, literally following. If somebody goes and you walk behind him, it's تَبِعْتُهُ. تَبِعْتُ بِلَالًا عِنْدَمَا خَرَجَ مِنَ الْمَسْجِدِ, I followed him. But اتَّبَعَ is to follow in the metaphorical sense. To do as he wants you to do. إِنِ اتَّبَعْتُمْ شُعَيْبًا, وَي شُعَيْبًا منصوب مفعول به, إن اتبعتم شعيبا إنكم إذن لخاسرون. So there's no fa here. Yeah, because of لام, it is now جواب القسم. It is no more جواب الشرط, it is جواب القسم. إذن اتبعتم شعيبا إنكم إذن, in that case, لخاسرون. We have got إنا plus لام. Inna attached to the ism and lam attached to the khabar of inna. لئن اتبعتم شعيبا إنكم إذا لخاسرون. So without لام إن اتبعتم شعيبا فإنكم. So when something comes, something goes. If لام comes, فا goes. The second ayah, لئن أذقنا الإنسان منا رحمة ثم نزعناه منه نزعناها منه إنه ليئوس كفور. لئن أذقنا, if we gave man a taste of mercy, أذاق, you know, ذاق is to taste, ذاق يذوق. If we change it to باب أفعل, أذاق يذيق, to make him taste. لئن أذقنا الإنسان, we gave man a taste of رحمة منا, a taste of mercy from us. ثم نزعناها منه, then took it away from him. نزع ينزع, نزع means to take, pull out. نزع ينزع. ثم نزعناه منه, نزعناها, ها refers to رحمة, منه, ها refers to man. إنه ليأوس كفور, then he is despairing. يأس ييأس, and this is يأوس, like كفور, and the measure of, and the pattern of فعول, غفور, يأوس كفور, عبوس. ليأوس كفور, he is despairing and ungrateful. كافر, literal meaning of the word is ungrateful, being ungrateful to a man. Somebody does good to him and he does not recognize it. That is kafur, kufran. لَئِنْ أَذَقْنَا الْإِنسَانَ مِنَّا رَحْمَةً ثُمَّ نَزَعْنَاهُ نَزَعْنَاهَا مِنْهُ إِنَّهُ. So إِنَّ here is جواب القسم, not جواب الشرط, because of لام. آية 3, قالوا لئن أكله الذئب ونحن أصبة إنا إذا لخاسرون. قالوا, they said, that is the brothers of Yusuf عليه السلام, in Surah Yusuf. قالوا لئن أكله الذئب, يعقوب عليه السلام was afraid that a wolf may eat him, any animal may eat him, when they wanted to take him to the take him out. He was afraid, he has his own apprehension. So they said, لَئِنْ أَكَلَهُ الذِّئِبُ, if a wolf was to eat him, should eat him, وَنَحْنُ أُصْبَى, وَوَوَ الْحَالِ, while we are a strong band of people, a group of people, أُصْبَةٌ is a group, and a very strong group, وَنَحْنُ أُصْبَةٌ وَوَوَ الْحَالِ. So they were 10 brothers. Yusuf alayhi salam was the 11th. So, لَئِنْ أَكَلَهُ الذِّئِبُ, if a wolf should eat him, while we are a strong band of people, إِنَّا إِذَنْ لَخَاسِرُونَ, then we are losers. We have been in loss. That is a bad name for us. Such a strong group of people and they are not able to protect. Yeah. So here, لَئِنْ أَكَلَهُ إِنَّا, that is jawab al-qasam, not jawab al-shart, jawab al-qasam, no fa. If you drop lam here, in akalahu zaybu wa nahnu usba, we will say, fa inna idhan la khasirun. Fourth, la in wa la in ruji'tu ila rabbi, inna li indahu la husna, lal husna, wa la in ruji'tu. Raja'a, as we studied in a previous lesson, has got two meanings, transitive and intransitive. Raja, to return, and the other is to give back, take him back. وَلَئِنْ رُجِعْتُ, if I am made to return, I am returned, passive voice. وَلَئِنْ رُجِعْتُ إِلَىٰ رَبِّي, if I am taken back to my Lord, إِنَّ لِي عِنْدَهُ لَلْحُسْنَى, I will have with him the best. أحسن feminine, حسنى. إِنَّ لِي, عنده للحسنى. This lam, lam al-muzahlaqa, is attached to what? Yes, attached to? What is al-husna here? Ism inna. Because the khabar is shibh jumla. Shibh jumla, as we have seen in the fi dhalika la ibratan. Inna fi dhalika la ibrat. Inna fi dhalika la ayatin. We studied that. So, lal husna. Al husna is the ism inna. And li is the khabar. Shibh jumla. Inna li indahu lal husna. Lal husna. Is it clear? Wala in ruji'tu ila rabbi inna li indahu lal husna. 5. Wala in qutiltum fi sabilillahi aw muttum lamaghfiratun min Allah wa rahmatun khayrun mimma yajma'un. Wala in qutiltum, if you were to be killed, if you are to be killed fi sabilillah and in the cause of Allah, aw muttum or died, if you were killed or died in the way of Allah, in the cause of Allah, lamaghfiratun min Allah. Here only lam, as we have seen before, lam only, either lam or inna are both. So here only lam, lamaghfiratun min Allah. If you are killed in the cause of Allah or you die, forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and mercy are better, mimma yajma'un, better than what people gather, amass, that is wealth and property. Yajma'un, yajma'un nas, what people gather of wealth and property and worldly things. Maghfiratun min Allah, forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and mercy is better than, are better than what they amass, what they gather. 6. Wala in sabartum lahuwa khayrun lissabirin. Again lam only here. Wala in sabartum, if you have patience, then lahuwa, it is, that is, patience is, having patience, forbearance is better for those who have patience. وَلَئِنْ صَبَرْتُمْ لَهُوَ خَيْرٌ لِلصَّابِرِينَ. Lam here, we have seen inna plus lam. Only inna we don't have. And we have only lam. So these are examples of جواب القسم. It is jumla ismiya muthbata, without negative particle. Number 2, جواب القسم الجملة الاسمية المنفية. Now yesterday we saw that jumla ismiya manfiya, all negative sentences do not need emphasis. If jawab al-qasam is negative, it doesn't need any emphasis. We have seen that. So here, لَإِن بَسَطَّ إِلَيَّ يَدَكَ لِتَقْتُلَنِي مَا أَنَا بِبَاسِطٍ يَدِيَ إِلَيْكَ لِأَقْتُلَكَ إني أخاف الله رب العالمين. لئن بسطت, بسط يبسط is to extend or stretch. بسط يبسط. باسط is one of the names of Allah. باسط, بسط يبسط is to extend, to stretch. بسط. بَلْ يَدَاهُ مَبْسُوطَتَانْ. In the Quran, Allah's two hands are widely stretched out. لَإِنْ بَسَطَّ إِلَيَّ towards me, يَدِي يَدَكَ. لَإِنْ بَسَطَّ إِلَيَّ يَدَكَ, if you extend your hand towards me, for what? لِتَقْتُلَنِي, to kill me. مَا أَنَا بِبَاسِطٍ يَدِيَ إِلَيْكَ, I'm not going to stretch my hand towards you. Ma ana bi basitin yadiya. It's yadi, but yadiya is for phonetic ease. ما أنا بباسط يدي إليك. I'm not going to extend my hand towards you لأقتلك to kill you. إني أخاف الله رب العالمين. I'm afraid of Allah سبحانه وتعالى, the Lord of the universe. I wrote here, قال هابيل لقابيل, one of the two sons of Adam عليه السلام, هابيل and قابيل. قابيل said this to قابيل. So here, لئن بسطت إلي يدك لتقتلني, ما أنا. If you drop the lamb, you say in basatta ilayya yadaka li taqtulani. How do you say? Fama ana. With ma, if the jawab shart has ma, it takes fa. Fama ana. La in basatta ilayya yadaka li taqtulani. Why is taqtula mansub? Li'an. Because of an, which should come after lam, lam ta'lil. Of course you can omit it. Yadaka li taqtulani. Ma ana bi basitin yadi. Yadiya ilayka li aqtulaka. Inni akhafu Allah rabbal alameen. So here, ma ana bi basitin. Jumla ismiya manfiya. It doesn't take fa. As it should have taken had it been the jawabul shart. Second ayah, wala in ittaba'ta ahwa'ahum ba'dama ja'aka min al-'ilm ma laka min Allah min waliyyin wala waq. Wala in ittaba'ta, same word ittaba'a, if you follow ahwa'ahum, hawan, hawa means whims and fancies, desires. Hawan, plural is ahwaun. Walain ittaba'ta ahwa'ahum, if you were to follow their inclinations, the desires, ba'dama ja'aka min al-'ilmi, ba'dama, what kind of ma is this? Masdariya, ma'al masdariya, ba'dama ja'aka min al-ilm, after what has come to you in the shape of ilm, knowledge. That is, after the knowledge that has come to you, if you were to follow their desires, after the knowledge that has come to you, ba'dama ja'aka min al-ilmi, ma'alaka min Allahi min waliyyin. This is jawabul qasam. Ma laka, you don't have min Allah, against Allah, min waliyin. What type of min is this? Ma laka min Allah min waliyin. Ma laka min Allah min waliyin. Please. No. Zaida. Min zaida. Hal min jadid. Hal min mazid. Ma jaa. Min ahadin, nobody has come. Ma jaa min ahadin. So, walain ittaba'ta ahwa'ahum ba'da ma jaaka min al-'ilm, ma laka min Allahi min waliyin. The first min Allah, of course, that is, yes. Min waliyin. If you follow their desires after the knowledge that has come to you, you have against Allah no friend, min waliyin, protecting friend. Wala waq. What is waq? Waqa yaqi, ism al-fa'il, waq. Waqa waqin. Al-waqi. Waqina, azab al-nar, waqina. وَقَيَقِقِ. So ism al-fa'il وَاقِن, protector. وَقَى, to protect, and وَاقِن, protector. وَلِيٌ is protecting friend, ally. وَلَيْنِ اتَّبَعْتَ أَهْوَاهُمْ بَعْدَ مَا جَاءَكَ مِنَ الْعِلْمِ مَا لَكَ مِنَ اللَّهِ من ولي ولا واق. Is that clear? Now we have جواب الجملة الفعلية فعلها ماض منفي. Now we have seen here جملة اسمية مثبتة منفية. Now الجواب is what? جملة فعلية with a ماضي verb. But مثبت we don't have examples. There is one example but that needs a different type of treatment. منفي. وَلَئِنْ أَتَيْتَ الَّذِينَ أُوتُوا الْكِتَابَ بِكُلِّ آيَةٍ بِكُلِّ آيَةٍ مَتَّبَعُوا قِبْلَتَكَ. This is about qibla, change of qibla from Jerusalem to Mecca. وَلَئِنْ أَتَيْتَ أَتَى يَأْتِ to come, but أَتَى بِ means to bring. وَلَئِنْ أَتَيْتَ if you bring الَّذِينَ أُوتُوا الْكِتَابَ those who have been given the book, Jews and Christians. وَلَئِنْ أَتَيْتَ الَّذِينَ أُوتُوا الْكِتَابَ. So here الَّذِينَ إعراب, what is the إعراب of الَّذِينَ? في محل نصب مفعول به. أتاني, he came to me. أتاني, أتيته, I went to him. So it takes مفعول. So ولئن أتيت الذين مفعول به, أوتوا الكتابة صلة الموصول, and العائد أوتوا الواو. الذين أوتوا الكتابة بكل آية. If you were to bring to them all proofs, all proofs, every proof, if you were to bring to me every proof that you have, وَلَيْنَ أَتَيْتَ الَّذِينَ أُوتُوا الْكِتَابَ بِكُلِّ آيَةٍ, if you were to give them, present to them every proof that you have of changing the qibla, مَتَّبَعُوا قِبْلَتَكَ, they will not follow your qibla. They will not follow your qibla. So here, مَتَّبَعُوا, جُمْلَ فِعْلِيَّ, فِعْلُهَا مَاضٍ. جُمْلَ فِعْلِيَّ with a ماضي verb. And negative or positive here? Negative. وَلَئِنْ أَتَيْتَ الَّذِينَ أُوتُوا الْكِتَابَ بِكُلِّ آيَةٍ مَتَّبَعُوا قِبْلَتَكَ. And the second ayah, وَلَئِنْ زَالَتَا إِنْ أَمْسَكَهَا مِنْ أَحَدٍ مِنْ بَعْدِهِ. وَلَئِنْ زَالَتَا, the ayah before that speaks of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala holding the heavens and the earth in their orbit, yes, holding them in their proper course, so that they do not leave the orbit and go away. And here, وَلَئِنْ زَالَتَا, this is مُثَنَّة. The heavens on one side and the earth on the other side. Zala. Zala is to leave the course, to fall, to be off course. Zala. Off the course. فَإِنْ زَالَتَا, if they should leave the course, إِنْ أَمْسَكَهَا مِنْ أَحَدٍ مِنْ بَعْدِهِ. إِنْ, please note, this in is negative in. We have not seen it very, very much, or even one time we haven't seen it. So in has got another meaning. It is no, just like ma, negative ma. It's called in an nafiya. We have in a shartiya. This is in an nafiya. وَلَئِنْ زَالَتَا, if they were to leave their course, إِنْ أَمْسَكَهَا مِنْ أَحَدٍ, again مِنْ, this مِنْ الزَّائِدَ, no one else after him will hold them to the course. إِنْ أَمْسَكَهَا, أَمْسَكَهَا is to hold, We have seen this. وَلَئِنْ زَالَتَا. So زَالَتَا, where is the فاعل? Alif. زَالَتَا is Alif. وَإِنْ زَالَتَا, if they went out of course, of the course, إِنْ أَمْسَكَهَا مِنْ أَحَدٍ. This is the subject. مِنْ أَحَدٍ here is فاعل, but مجرور. مجرور بسبب, because of مِنْ الزَّائِدَة. مِنْ الزَّائِدَة. That is why we call it الزَّائِدَة. Because grammatically, in regard to إعراب, it should be removed. So as if we say, إِنْ أَمْسَكَهَا أَحَدٌ مِنْ بَعْدِهِ. No one else after him will be able to bring it back to the course. وَلَئِنْ زَالَتَا إِنْ أَمْسَكَهَا مِنْ أَحَدٍ مِنْ بَعْدِهِ. Now the fourth group, الجملة الفعلية, فعلها مضارع مثبت. مضارع مثبت. Now the Quran contains lots of ayat of this type. The others are few. But here, جملة فعلية فعلها مضارع. We got quite a lot of ayat. It's so here, as you know, we say, if wallahi la usafiranna, it should have noon thaqila or khafifa also, with lam attached before the verb and noon after the verb. Wallahi la usafiranna, wallahi la ahfazanna al-qur'ana. So here you will have the verb, the jawab, in this type of verb. لَإِن لَمْ تَنْتَهِ لَأَرْجُمَنَّكَ. There is Ibrahim alayhi salam, his father tells Ibrahim alayhi salam, لَإِن لَمْ تَنْتَهِ, if you do not desist. انتهى, ينتهي is to come to an end, bring to an end. إِن لَمْ تَنْتَهِ, if you do not desist from what you are doing, لَأَرْجُمَنَّكَ, I will pelt you with the stones. Rajama yarjo. لَإِن لَمْ تَنْتَهِ. تَنْتَهِ is majzum. What is the alam of jazm? Dropping of the ya. Actually, تَنْتَهِ. انْتَهَا. انْتَهِ. وَإِن لَمْ تَنْتَهِ. The ya has been dropped. وَإِن لَمْ تَنْتَهِ. If you do not desist, لَأَرْجُمَنَّكَ. I will stone you. I'll stone you. If it is without lam, we will say لَإِنْ لَمْ تَنْتَهِ رَجَمْتُكَ. رَجَمْتُكَ. But here لَأَرْجُمَنَّكَ, I will stone you. قَالُوا لَإِنْ لَمْ تَنْتَهِ يَا لُوطُ لَتَكُونَنَّ مِنَ الْمُخْرَجِينَ. قَالُوا لَإِنْ لَمْ تَنْتَهِ, it is said to Lut alayhi salam. They said, that is as follows, the people of his tribe, they said, لَإِنْ لَمْ تَنْتَهِ, if you do not desist from what you are doing, يَا لُوتْ أَوْ لُوتْ, لَتَكُونَنَّ, you will be, لَتَكُونَ, you will be مِنَ الْمُخْرَجِينَ, one of those who are deported. أَخْرَجَ يُخْرِجُ, اسم الفاعل مُخْرِجٌ, اسم المفعول مُخْرَجٌ. مُخْرَجُونَ, مُخْرَجِينَ. لَتَكُونَنَّ مِنَ الْمُخْرَجِينَ, you will be one of those deported from the country. لَإِنْ لَمْ تَنْتَهِ يَا لُوطُ لَتَكُونَنَّ مِنَ الْمُخْرَجِينَ, will deport you from the country. Ayah 3, وَلَإِنْ سَأَلْتَهُمْ مَنْ خَلَقَهُمْ لَيَقُولُنَّ اللَّهُ. وَلَإِنْ سَأَلْتَهُمْ, if you were to ask them, that is a people of Quraysh in Mecca. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, لَإِنْ سَأَلْتَهُمْ, if you were to ask them, مَنْ خَلَقَهُمْ, who created them, لَيَقُولُنَّ اللَّهُ, they will definitely say Allah. So this was a belief which was not in dispute. They believed in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the creator, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the controller of the heavens and the earth. But when it came to the matter of worship, they said, we worship Allah and also we worship our deities. وَلَئِنْ سَأَلْتَهُمْ مَنْ خَلَقَهُمْ لَيَقُولُنَّ اللَّهُ. Number 4, وَلَقَدْ أُوحِيَ إِلَيْكَ وَإِلَى الَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِكَ لئن أشركت ليحبطن عملك. ولقد أوحي, it was revealed to you, أوحى, يوحي, but this is أو أوحي مجهول. ولقد أوحي إليك, to you, وإلى الذين من قبلك, and to those who were before you, لئن أشركت, لئن أشركت, if you associate someone with Allah, if you were to fall in the sin of shirk, وَلَئِنْ أَشْرَكْتَ. أَشْرَكَ, which verb is this? Fourth. إِشْرَاكَ, أَشْرَكَ, يُشْرِكُ. اسم الفاعل مُشْرِكٌ. وَلَئِنْ أَشْرَكْتَ لَيَحْبَطَنَّ عَمَلُكَ. حَبِطَ, يَحْبَطُ. حَبِطَتْ أَعْمَالُهُمْ. حَبِطَتْ أَعْمَالُهُمْ. حَبِطَ is to go in vain. حَبِطَتْ أَعْمَالُهُمْ. لَيَحْبَطَنَّ عَمَلُكَ, your deeds, good deeds, will go in vain, will be cancelled. لَئِنْ أَشْرَكْتَ لَيَحْبَطَنَّ عَمَلُكَ وَلَتَكُونَنَّ مِنَ الْخَاسِرِينَ, and you will be one of the losers, you will be among the losers. خَسِرَ, يَخْسَرَ. وَلَتَكُونَنَّ, معطوف, معطوف. لَيَحْبَطَنَّ عَمَلُكَ وَلَتَكُونَنَّ, معطوف. وَلَئِنْ لَمْ يَفْعَلْ مَا آمُرُهُ لَيُسْجَنَنَّ وَلَيَكُونًا مِنَ الصَّاغِرِينَ. Now this needs a little concentration. وَلَئِنْ لَمْ يَفْعَلْ, this is in Surah Yusuf, and this is said by the wife of the Aziz of Misr, the man who bought Yusuf alayhi salam. And she wanted to have, she had evil designs with Yusuf alayhi salam, and when he desisted, she says, "Wala in lam yaf'al," if he does not do what I command him to do, "Wala in lam yaf'al ma amuruhu." Here, amuruhu is, what is it? No, the sentence. Salatul Mausul. Salatul Mausul. Where is the Aid? No, no, not who. Ma, see, he's speaking of what? That which. No, no. Ma amuruhu bihi. The Aid is mahzuf. Ma amuruhu bihi. Amartuhu bihi. I commanded him to do this. You follow me? So, ma amuruhu bihi, what I command him to do, if he does not carry out my command and does not do what I want him to do, la yusjananna, he will be imprisoned. Sajana yasjunu, la yusjananna. Is it active or passive? Passive, la yusjananna. La yusjananna. She indicates here, she doesn't want him to be killed. Follow me, for all evil designs. So he says, la yusjananna. She mentions the punishment, type of punishment she wants. Ma la yusjananna wa la yakunan min as-saghirin. Please note here, la yakunan. How is it written? This is actually, this is noon khafifa. ثقيلة ألبي يكونن, خفيفة is يكونن. But in the Mus'haf it is written with تنوين, as if it is تنوين. It's not تنوين. You will find this also in Surah Al-Alaq. There are two places. This is one place. The other place in Surah Al-Alaq you will find نصفعن, I think. So it's written as if it is tanween. It's not tanween. Please note this. La yakunan. It's actually known khafifa. Min as-saghirin. Yakunan min as-saghirin means debased, despicable. صغير. صغير is of course you know صغير, but صغير means he will be among the humiliated. Among the humiliated, he will not have respect. وَلَا إِنْ لَمْ يَفْعَلْ مَا آمُرُهُ آمُرُ. You know, we have seen يَأْكُلُ تَأْكُلُ but آكُلُ يَأْخُذُ تَأْخُذُ but آخُذُ becomes آ أَمَرَ يَأْمُرُ تَأْمُرُ نَأْمُرُ but آمُرُ. مَا آمُرُ بِهِ بِهِ of course is not there. لَا يُسْجَنَنَّ he will be imprisoned. وَلَا يَكُونَنْ مِنَ الصَّاغِرِينَ he will be of those who are humiliated. Now number 6, it needs little concentration. لَمَنْ تَبِعَكَ مِنْهُمْ لَأَمْلَأَنَّ جَهَنَّمَ مِنْكُمْ أَجْمَعِينَ. See the lam, where has been, where is it attached to? مَنْ مَنْ شَرْطِيَة مَنْ شَرْطِيَة. And this lam, what is this lam? اللام الموطية للقسم. Just like لأين, this is لمن. This لام is لام الموطية للقسم. As if you say, والله من تبعك. Is it as if you say, والله من تبعك. لمن تبعك منهم. He whoever follows you, whoever of those of them who follows you. Allah says this to Shaitan. لَمَنْ تَبِعَكَ whoever follows, whoever of those who follows you, لَأَمْلَأَنَّ جَهَنَّمَ I will fill the hell مِنْكُمْ fill the hell with you, أجمعين, together, all together. So مِنْكُمْ refers to whom? Those who follow and those who follow him also. Those whom they follow. That is the Satan and those who follow. وَلَئِنْ لَمَنْ تَبِعَكَ مِنْهُمْ لَأَمْلَأَنَّ مَلَأَ يَمْلَأُ لَأَمْلَأَنَّ جَهَنَّمَ. جَهَنَّمَ is مَفْعُول بِهِ. Why doesn't have تنوين? جَهَنَّمَ, not جَهَنَّمَن. ممنوع من الصرف جهنم proper name feminine proper name feminine proper name جهنم is feminine and proper name جهنم. لأملأن جهنم منكم أجمعين together all together that is those who follow and those whom they follow. So please note here لمن لام. So we have different types of lam. We have seen lam, lam al-ta'lil, and lam al-muzahara, lam al-amr. And then we have seen lam al-taqwiya. Lam al-taqwiya. وَمَا اللَّهُ يُرِيدُ ظُلْمًا لِلْعَالَمِينَ. Lam al-taqwiya. And this is al-lam al-mutiya lil-qasam. لَمَنْ تَبِعَكَ مِنْهُمْ لَأَمْلَأَنَّ جَهَنَّمَ مِنْكُمْ أَجْمَعِينَ. 7. وَلَئِنْ مُتْتُمْ أَوْ قُتِلْتُمْ لَإِلَى اللَّهِ تُحْشَرُونَ. Here you, I need your attention. لَئِنْ مُتْتُمْ if you are killed, if you die. مُتْتُمْ مَاتَ يَمُوتُ this is not مَاتَ يَمَاتُ مَاتَ يَمُوتُ. وَلَئِنْ مُتْتُمْ if you die أَوْ قُتِلْتُمْ or you are killed. Passive voice, huh? لَإِلَى اللَّهِ تُحْشَرُونَ. Now bear with me, why is there no نُونُ الثَّقِيلَ نُونُ الْخَفِيفَ and تُحْشَرُونَ? Because لام is not attached to the verb. وَلَسَوْفَ يُعْطِيكَ. لَإِلَى اللَّهِ تُحْشَرُونَ. To Allah will they be gathered. So if you say لا تحشرن إلى الله لا تحشرن إلى الله. So for example, I'll give an example here. والله لا أسافرن إلى مكة، والله لا أسافرن إلى مكة. It should have noon, it should have lam. Is it right? والله لا أسافرن إلى مكة. But suppose I were to say والله, your friend says no, we go to some other place, we go to Cairo. I said no. So I want to emphasize, and I say والله لا إلى مكة then how do we say أسافرن or أسافر. I will say والله لا إلى مكة أسافر. I'll go only to Mecca. والله لا إلى مكة أسافر. Here it will not be emphasized with noon. Here it will be emphasized this is wajib. Here no, because the lam is separated from the verb. That you have read in the book. So here, وَلَئِن مُتْتُمْ أَوْ قُتِلْتُمْ لَإِلَى اللَّهِ تُحْشَرُونَ. حَشَرَ يَحْشُرُ is to gather. لَإِلَى اللَّهِ lam has been attached to إِلَى, not to the verb. وَلَئِن مُتْتُمْ أَوْ قُتِلْتُمْ لَإِلَى اللَّهِ تُحْشَرُونَ. Is that clear? Please remember that this is a very good example of how the verb in Jawab al-Qasam is not emphasized with noon if the lam is separated. Now, as we have seen, if the verb is negative, it does not need any emphasis. So you will say, for example, wallahi la usafiru ila Hamilton. Wallahi la usafiru. We don't say wallahi la usafiranna ila Hamilton. La usafiranna, that is positive. But wallahi la usafiru al-yawm. Wallahi la usafiru ila Hamilton al-yawm. So la usafiru without any emphasis. So here we have قُلْ لَئِنْ اجْتَمَعَتِ الْإِنْسُ وَالْجِنُّ عَلَىٰ أَنْ يَأْتُوا. The جواب الجملة الفعلية فعلها مضارع منفي. قُلْ لَئِنْ اجْتَمَعَتِ الْإِنْسُ وَالْجِنُّ. If the jinn and human beings and jinn were to come together, عَلَىٰ أَنْ يَأْتُوا بِمِثْلِ هَذَا الْقُرْآنِ, to bring something similar to this Quran, la ya'tuna bimithlihi, la ya'tuna bimithlihi, they will not bring something similar to this. So la ya'tuna, this is jawab al qasam, but does not take noon, is not emphasized because it is negative. La in ukhriju la yakhrujuna ma'ahum. We'll stop here and complete this in the next session. وآخر دعوانا الحمد لله رب العالمين. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين, والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. Brothers and sisters, we will complete the last two آيات. قل لئن اجتمعت الإنس والجن على أن يأتوا بمثل هذا القرآن لا يأتون بمثله. Here, جواب القسم لا يأتون بمثله. It is not it doesn't have emphasis because it is negative. The last ayah, لَا إِنْ أُخْرِجُوا لَا يَخْرُجُونَ مَعْهُمْ وَلَا إِنْ قُوتِلُوا لَا يَنْصُرُونَهُمْ. This is from Surah Al-Hashr. I would suggest that you read Surah Al-Hashr because there are two more examples of this in Surah Al-Hashr. I've given only two examples here. There are more. لَا إِنْ أُخْرِجُوا لَا يَخْرُجُونَ مَعْهُمْ. Here it refers to the kuffar, the kuffar of Medina, and the Jews who were in Medina. لَإِنْ أُخْرِجُوا, they had told them, promised them, if you are sent out of Medina, we will also go with you. Go out with you. We will also go out with you. But Allah says, لَإِنْ أُخْرِجُوا, if they were deported, لَا يَخْرُجُونَ مَعْهُمْ, they will not go out with them. لَإِنْ أُخْرِجُوا لَا يَخْرُجُونَ مَعْهُمْ. وَلَإِنْ قُوتِلُوا, if war is waged against them, قَاتَلَ يُقَاتِلُ, to make war to. وَلَإِنْ قُوتِلُوا مجهول, if war is waged against them, لا ينصرونهم, they will not support them. نصر ينصروا, they will not help them, support them. لا إن أخرجوا لا يخرجون معهم, negative. ولا إن قوتلوا لا ينصرونهم. This is Surah Al-Hashr. Now at the end, in this box, I have ayah. It has two different jawab of two different nature. Let us read. وَإِذْ تَأَذَّنَ رَبُّكُمْ لَإِنْ شَكَرْتُمْ لَأَزِيدَنَّكُمْ وَلَإِنْ كَفَرْتُمْ إِنَّ عَذَابِي لَشَدِيدٌ. وَإِذْ تَأَذَّنَ, إِذْ, at the beginning of the sentence, is remember when. Yeah. وَإِذْ تَأَذَّنَ, when, remember when your Lord proclaimed, تَأَذَّنَ, بَابْتَفَعَّلَ, from أَذِنَ, أَذِنَ, to permit, أَذِنَ يَأْذَنُ, تَأَذَّنَ, أَذَّنَ, to make أَذَان, أَذَّنَ, تَأَذَّنَ, this is five. وَإِذْ تَأَذَّنَ رَبُّكُمْ, remember when Allah, when your Lord proclaimed, لَإِنْ شَكَرْتُمْ لَأَزِيدَنَّكُمْ, لَإِنْ شَكَرْتُمْ, if you give thanks, لَأَزِيدَنَّكُمْ, I will increase you in favor. لَأَزِيدَنَّكُمْ, you see here, جواب, لَأَزِيدَنَّكُمْ, because it is future. لَإِنْ شَكَرْتُمْ لَأَزِيدَنَّكُمْ, مُثْبَت, yes. If there is no لام, you say, إِنْ شَكَرْتُمْ زِدْتُكُمْ, إِنْ شَكَرْتُمْ, if you thank, زِدْتُكُمْ, it's ماضي. إِنْ شَكَرْتُمْ زِدْتُكُمْ, I will increase you. I will increase you in favor. وَلَإِنْ كَفَرْتُمْ, but if you are ungrateful, لَإِنْ كَفَرْتُمْ, شَكَرَ, كَفَرَ, شَكَرَ is to be thankful, كَفَرَ is to be ungrateful. وَلَإِنْ كَفَرْتُمْ, if you are ungrateful, إِنَّ عَذَابِي لَشَدِيدٌ, there is no fa here. Without lam, you say, إِنْ كَفَرْتُمْ فَإِنَّ عَذَابِي لَشَدِيدٌ. So, وَلَإِنْ كَفَرْتُمْ إِنَّ عَذَابِي لَشَدِيدٌ, if you are ungrateful, my punishment is severe. So, please note, the jumla ismiya, if it is jawab al-qasam, it will be, as the example I gave you, إِنْ أَرَدْتَ, إِنْ أَرَدْتَ عَنْ تدرس اللغة العربية let us have in لَإِنْ عربية إني مستعد. You can also say إني لا مستعد. Or you can say لا أنا مستعد. This is the best. إني لا مستعد. You can have only إني, إنا. You can have only لا. Of course, in the Quran we have seen two examples of لا هو, only لام. إني مستعد. إني لا مستعد. لا أنا مستعد. This is جواب القسم. If it is جملة اسمية مثبتة. Alhamdulillah, we have finished this. Now we go back to the last lesson. We have the exercises that which we did not do. Page 133. Question 1. Identify the following in this surah. A. A nominal sentence functioning as a second mafrool bihi. A nominal sentence functioning as a second mafrool bihi. Uma adraka malaqaba. Uma adraka. Kaf is the first object. Malaqaba, this jumla ismiya, is the second object. B. A nominal sentence functioning as a khabar of a mubtada. Khabar of a mubtada. Here, example, الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا بِآيَاتِنَا هُمْ أَصْحَابُ الْمَشْأَمَةِ هُمْ أَصْحَابُ الْمَشْأَمَةِ. This is jumla ismiya. هُمْ ابْتَدَى أَصْحَابُ خَبَرْ مَشْأَمَةِ مُضَافِ إِلَيْهِ. And that is the khabar of وَالَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا بِآيَاتِنَا صِلَةُ الْمَوْصُولِ. See, a khabar whose مُبْتَدَى has been omitted. فك رقبة. فك وما أدراك ما العقبة. فك رقبة. So it is here. وما أدراك ما العقبة. What will explain to you what is what عقبة is, what summit is. So the reply is فك رقبة. This فك is خبر. مبتدأ is here. عقبة here. فك رقبة. D, the مفعول به of a مصدر. Yes. أو إطعام في يوم ذي مسغبة يتيما. يتيما is the مفعول به of إطعام. إطعام, just as a verb has مفعول به, the مصدر also has مفعول به. As I told you, دراستي اللغة العربية. كانت في تورونتو. دراستي اللغة العربية. My study of Arabic. E. Two nouns belong to the Asma al-Khamsa. One of them being majroor, the other being mansoor. Yeah. Miskinan ذا matraba. ذا, that is mansoob. And في يوم ذي مسغبة, that is majroor. F, a musanna noun. Shafatain. Najdain, we have wahadainahun najdain, walisanan wa shafatain. Ainain. Yes, all of them are mansoob. Alam najdal lahu ainaini, maful, shafataini, ma'toof. وهديناه النجدين also مفعول of هدا. جواب القسم. Yes, لا أقسم بهذا البلد وأنت حل بهذا البلد ووالدي وما ولد. That's a قسم. لقد خلقنا الإنسان في كباد. We have created man in toil. That is the جواب القسم. It is جملة فعلية, فعل ماض مثبت, and that is why it should be emphasized with لقد. مصدر ميمي مرحمة مقربة مزغبة. yes. Correct the following sentences. They're wrong. والله فرحت بلقائك اليوم. والله لقد فرحت. I'm glad to see you today. والله لقد فرحت. فرحت only is not correct. با رأيت في المسجد رجلا ذو لحية بيضاء. Yes, رجلاً ذا. ذو is مرفوع. It is not. رجلاً is منصوب. رأيت في المسجد رجلاً ذا لحية بيضاء. Why بيضاء بفتحة؟ لحية. Why don't we say بيضاء؟ ممنوع من الصرف because of the ألف التأنيث. So, ذو لحية بيضاء, فتحة here is a deputy of the كسرة. What does لا in لا أقسم signify? Yes, it is not, doesn't negate the verb, but it negates something, that an idea that goes before that. Rewrite the following sentence using أتحسب with the lightened أن. لم يفهم كلامك أحد. لم يفهم كلامك أحد. أتحسب أن لم يفهم كلامك أحد. أن أتحسب do you think أن لم يفهم كلامك أحد. أتحسب أن لم يفهم كلامك أحد. أحد فاعل, كلام مفعول به, and an is lightened form of anna, and its ism is who, which is dhamir ashan, but is omitted there. What is literal meaning of fakku raqaba? To untie the rope in the round the neck, or to free the neck. And what is meant by this expression? Freeing a slave. فَكُّ رَقَبَةٍ, freeing a slave. What are the two meanings of lisan? Tongue and tongue. Tongue is this tongue and the other one is mother tongue. Mother tongue. In English also you say tongue and tongue. So use this word in two sentences of your own, composition, each with one of the two meanings. أخرج لسانك. قال للطبيب أخرج لسانك. The doctor said to me, bring out your tongue. Or show me. أريني لسانك. أريني لسانك. That is the tongue. The other one is أتعرف اللسان العربية. أتعرف اللسان العربية. Yes. What does ثم mean in the following sentences? As I told you, ثم has got two meanings. One is delayed succession of the act and delayed succession of the information. تعشيت ثم نمت. This is delayed succession of the act. I had supper and I slept. هو عالم كبير ثم إنه كان قاضيا مدة طويلة. He is a great عالم ثم إنه كان. Moreover, in addition, ثم إنه كان قاضيا. In addition to that, he was a judge for a long time. ثم إنه كان. So in that case, it is delayed information. I gave you the first information, then I gave you the second information after that. So it's delayed information. It doesn't mean that first of all he was alim and immediately after some time he became. No. It means in addition to that information I gave you before, this is another information. Give the plural of the following nouns: shafatun, shifahun, kasra. Shafatun, shifahun. As I told you, shafatun, the third radical has been lost, which is ha. That is why we have shifahun in plural, it comes back. And in the verb shafaha, yushafihu, to talk face to face, the ha comes back. And the nasab, ism mansub, is shafahiyun, labial, belong to the lips. Shafahiyun are oral also. Ikhtibarun shafahiyun, oral examination. Najdun, nujudun. Najd is the highland, as lowland and highland. Najdun, as I told you, in the Arabian Peninsula, the central part of the Arabian Peninsula is highland. That is why it is called Najd even today. That part, it is geographically, it's Najd, it's highland. And also the administrative name is Najd. Lisanun, Alsinatun, it is another plural, Alsunun. Like Aharfun, Aharfun, Shahrun, Ashhurun, Lisanun, Alsunun. As I told you, language school, they say, Ma'ahadul Alsuni, Ma'ahad Al-Alsuni, Institute of Languages, Ma'ahadul Alsuni. Malun, Amwalun, Malun is actually Mawalun. Alif stands for Waw, Amwalun. Mawwala, to finance a project or something like that, you say Mawwala. Tamwil, Tamwil is Mawwala. What is the masdar? Tamwilun. Mawwala, to finance. Man, for example, man yumawwilu hadhal mashru'. Hadhal mashru'. Mashru' means project. Man yumawwilu hadhal mashru'a, who finances this project. Mawwala yumawwilu, yumawwilu tamwilan. Man yumawwilu hadhal mashru'a. There is another word. It is not connected with this, but I just wanted to tell you. Thamarun, you know thamar? It's not fruit, it's thamarun is the produce of a tree. It's not fruit in the sense that apple, no. Even rice is thamar. That is the produce of a tree, a thamar. And it's tathmara. Which bab is this? Tenth is tath mara. Masdar is tif, is tif marun. Istathmara means to invest. Istathmara. Istathmara, istathmiru, istithmarun. To invest. When I mentioned to you mawwala, I thought of istithmar. Malun, amwalun, raqabatun. Riqabun. It is in the Quran, twice it is mentioned, riqabun, in the sense of freeing the slaves. Riqabun. Narun, نيران. I told you there are quite a few number, nouns which have جار جيران نار نيران فار فئران تاج تيجان crowns. Yes. نار نيران يتيم. يتيم has got two plurals. يتاما which is مقصور. يتاما with ya. There is aitamun, aitamun, like auladun, yatimun, aitamun. Yatimun, aitamun. Alhamdulillah, we have finished the book.